relations at the University of Bradford, Dr. Afshin Shahi, says that fresh sanctions against Russia are not the answer.
Over the last 5 or 6 years, it's been very difficult to have a meaningful hope for a political transition, for a political solution for what is happening right now in Syria. Over the last couple of months, we were just beginning to raise our hopes for a more meaningful kind of set of negotiations. And at this time, we need a meaningful cooperation by every single player in the international community.
Are we going to get that now? Rex Tillerson is going. He's going to go to Moscow. Rex Tillerson, maybe Boris Johnson went, but Rex Tillerson is. That's another mixed message for us as well, isn't it, really? But
it's going to be very problematic. And to be honest, I'm not entirely sure why, in a time of uncertainty, the British Foreign Secretary is basically taking that type of a step. It is just like very difficult to understand to what end and exactly why he's taking a kind of that type of decision.
He's seeing that Europe is more of a priority to get the G7 leaders to unite together to have a message, perhaps bridge a gap between Washington and Europe. After all, the likes of Italy, Spain and Germany are very nervous about this gung-ho sort of military intervention in the Middle East. Do you think, in some ways, what Boris Johnson is going to do is try and bridge the gap between the US and the EU and try and get some sort of united diplomatic message to try and sort this out? After all, a political situation or solution is the way forward rather than a military one?
This is what he has been talking about. But again, as we have been seeing over the last 10 years, when it comes to foreign policy in the Middle East, sometimes they take an action and then they think about it. At the moment, Johnson is talking about more sanctions against Russia. And in my opinion, this is only going to jeopardize the future of the peace process in Syria. And of course, there are some European nation states who are a little bit nervous about kind of escalation of further tension between kind of United States, United Kingdom and Russia. Nonetheless, the discourse, the political tone, the political language has changed radically over the last 7 or 8 days. And in my opinion, this does not inspire confidence, certainly when it comes to the peace negotiation and a meaningful political transition and solution for Syria.
Well, Boris Johnson and the rest of the G7 congratulate Donald Trump on the air.